Previously on Mad Men.
What's up, guys? What's happening? What's going on? I am just busy with my car again. I did speak about it in the car. But what is happening is two problems. If you watch my last video, you'd see at the end I got an engine light, and that was I actually put in the OBD2 scanner and I got a boost system, whatever. I was like, fuck, something broke. The car still drove right, but it just felt super sluggish, but it always felt a little bit sluggish. So what I did was I took it to this Merc Center in Ottery. I don't think I've seen this much Mercedes-Benz in my life. You get me, 63 all over the bloody place. 63. You gotta come here. You gotta come here, check it out. Okay, so what we're doing now is just running the diagnostics on the machine and says device not in use, so goodness.
For some reason on the 204, I decided to change this pipe.
Uh-huh.
I joined this pipe to the boost at the bottom. To like this plasticky pipe. And this, a lot of the time, it cracked.
I see this oil on the side there. See there's oil.
Yeah, that's just like, they put it in the worst.
Yeah, so we have Eunice here and Mani, owner of this place. You want to come here with your Mercedes-Benz, sort it out, because my bro, it's not like they don't know what's clapping, they know what's happening. And they take good care of you. This is how I called. You won't get any discount, but this is how I called. Eunice, one of the mechanics here, very knowledgeable.
No discounts here.
Yeah, guys, sorry, it's Mercedes-Benz, man. I can hook you up with like getting in contact, but that's about it. And they diagnose and they repair and whatever, and so much AMG is there, it's not even funny, but it's the case with AMGs. What we diagnosed was obviously that this pipe at the bottom here, it's a little connector between the top plastic pipe that goes into the supercharger and the bottom pipe that connects to this plastic like connector, the two, and it's hooked up via the two screws there. To get it off, you need to take that 2 hex screws. 10 hex screws on the side, that must come out, because that plastic actually keeps that old piece rigid. Once you get that too loose, you can loosen the clamp. The clamp that goes on the supercharger, that's a flat screwdriver, super easy. And then right to the bottom down there, we have another two, I think it's 8mm socket clamps. You can use a small socket and get to that fairly easy. Now, I didn't vlog me taking that off because I did it one night and I just was kind of experimenting and thinking, okay, I need to take it off because I need to get the measurements, because I can only imagine how much that costs at Mercedes-Benz. But it's such a simple piece of pipe. You can get the same diameter of like boost pipe, like that blue silicone pipe or whatever, and just replace it with that and you'd be fine. And it would actually be a little bit better also, because the silicone pipe shouldn't crack, whereas that cracked. And you can see the crack here. So anyways, I just Q-bonded it. I put it back on, that was like quick, it was like not even 35 minutes or so. Q-bond it back on again, because Q-bond like instantly dries. Put it on, and I had boost on the OBD2 scanner. I had boost, you can see here.
I'm gonna give it a button, just watch the power stuff quickly.
Getting boost, 11 psi, 11 12ish psi, but my foot isn't all the way flat down, but I am getting boost, which is a good thing, which means I fix that engine light, has not come back on again. Second problem, the valve cover on here. I replaced the valve cover gasket when I did the timing chain, and I didn't take it off again, but it has been leaking out the back corner here. Just this, if you're looking at the valve cover gasket, this back corner here. Now they do say on the forums that you need to put sealant on those corners because it leaks out there. Now it wasn't leaking for me, but over the while I guess it's been seeping, and it's now actually become a little bit worse of a leak, and it's leaking down the back of the engine, in down the back of the engine. So there you can see it's leaking,
and it's going all the way down the back onto that green wire there. So it's against the engine, that wire is attached to the engine. I don't know if you can see, but you can see it's wet. Then it goes down that wire, and that green wire is connected to the O2 sensor. So what is happening is the oil is running onto the O2 sensor, and this gets really warm. So I have this warm oil smell that just flipping. Let me just try and get the camera back. Yeah. Anyways, I'm just gonna use some prickly steel, not prickly steel, but I'm gonna use prickly valve cover gasket maker. So I'm gonna take off this valve cover and I'm gonna put gasket maker in there. Hopefully that works. I also think I'm pretty much tying that too tight. I'm almost dead sure because the others doesn't compress as much and I shouldn't go so tight. So what I'm gonna do is I can get another valve cover gasket. It's not an issue, but right now I can't get another valve cover gasket. You know what I mean? I'll have to buy one, and I think they're like 500 rand or something like that. Buy a Goldwagen. I don't know who else. If you can find one cheaper, that'd be cool. Because it's literally just a rubber seal and it's not like the spark plug ones. The spark plug ones by me are dry. They're perfectly fine. It's the outside one in the back corner that's leaking. So I'm just going to valve cover. Okay, I'm just going to gasket make it, and then I'm going to see if it stops leaking. Because what I'm worried about is the oil running onto the exhaust and actually setting a light. That shouldn't, because it doesn't get hot enough. But yeah, it's a bloody pain when you park it and then you smell oil. So let's get to that. Fairly simple, you just got to unplug the loom from the side. A lot of people will have a problem with this plastic. This plastic goes over here and it's zip tied to this. What I did was I actually broke this plastic. So it's broke just after where the valve cover gasket thingy is. I broke it. I broke this piece off and it's much easier to get it off now. You must get this pipe also off and then all this T8s, right, or E10s right around. All this E10s right around needs to become loose. And then when you pull it up, you want to pull it up and underneath out of this wire. So up over the cams and underneath. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just clean up here. And then I'm going to lay a nice bead from about here, from this nut, right around until that nut. So you can get that sealed. And what I'm using is Prattley. It's grey, I wish it was black, but it seems good enough. I just got it at the Midas. Should work, but I'm not going to lay a thick bead. I'm going to lay a nice thin one. The cool part is you can see where the gasket lays on there, so you can just nice thin one around. Once this is out, you can also just check your timing chain once you hear and see that it's still alright, you know, it's nice and stuff. My timing chain, that's the timing chain that I replaced in the previous video.
12 seconds later.
Yeah, now I'm just tightening it again and not. I don't have a torque wrench, so I'm not just keeping my hand on the top of the socket and tightening it real tight. But from this angle, as you can see, there is the handle and my hand is on top of this thing. I'm not gonna go any tighter than that. Okay. Okay, let's fasten the spark plugs. Put everything back together again.
Finally, I looked at the pads the other day. like months ago, and I'm like, they need to be changed. So I bought the pads and everything. And I'm now only getting this warning. What? It's the middle of November and I'm getting it now, so it's through now. And yeah, brake change! Yay!